rejoice and be glad in it, right? Amen. Today we're celebrating Children's Sabbath, which was established by the Children's Defense Fund many years ago under the direction of Miriam Edelman Wright, who is the author of the poem that we have been using at our offertory times. We've been emphasizing children who need help when they're hungry, homeless, abused, and in need of mental health issues. Today, our offering, special offering, is going to Wellspring, which houses children. We're delighted that Angela Carter, a friend of Pastor Roxy's, is here as our guest preacher this morning. Angela is the Associate Minister of Resurrection Life Ministries Church in Mitchell, Indiana. And she's served on the Walk to Emmaus, or been to the Walk to Emmaus, so some of you know her. We're glad that she's here with us today. If you have not filled out a yellow card requesting prayer for some need or some praise, we encourage you to do that. At this time, I'm going to ask that we stand as we sing the song, I Love to Tell the Story, right? No. Tell me the stories of Jesus, number 190. We're going to hear a story of Jesus today, okay? So the Hebrew people went to Jerusalem once a year to celebrate the Passover, the time when God brought the people out of Egypt to freedom. And Jesus was going up to Jerusalem too. And you know, people had been hearing him teach all around, and they wanted to come and be close to him. Even the children, they wanted to come and be close to Jesus. But Jesus' disciples told them no. Jesus is too busy. You can't see him. And Jesus said to the disciples, "Let the children come to me." And so they came one by one. And he gave them a hug and he blessed them. And he told his disciples that unless they become like one of those little children, they could not enter the kingdom of God. Well, I wonder how these children felt when the disciples told them no. Upset.
Angry.
Sad. Is that your sad face? Yeah, okay. Well, I wonder what the disciples felt when Jesus told them to let the children come to me.
Surprised.
Happy.
Confused.
Well, I wonder if there were some other children that didn't make it to see Jesus. They probably slept in. Well, I wonder if any of these kids came hungry.
Probably.
I wonder if any of them were homeless.
Probably.
I wonder if any of them were abandoned. I wonder what Jesus said to them when he picked them up and blessed them.
Hello.
God bless you.
No.
I don't think so, Lord. Okay. Let's bow our heads in prayer, okay? Gracious God, we thank you for these children, Ricky, Lauren, and Violet. And we thank you for all the children of the world, which includes each and every person here and out there. May we feel Jesus blessing us. In Jesus' name, amen. Now, I'm wondering for response time today, if you will take a tray, there's a bulletin there you could use, or a sheet of paper that maybe you could draw a picture of how you'd feel if you were in this circle with Jesus, okay? All right, so go get a tray. Thank you for coming forward.
Good morning, church. How is everybody this morning? Amen. Amen. I say, this is the day that the Lord hath made, so let us rejoice and be glad in it, right? Amen. All right, so first of all, we need these. We can't do anything without these. All right, so we have a couple of prayer, praise requests this morning. My granddaughter-in-law's family, as they mourn the loss of her father, request from Jackie Shields. We have prayer for Pastor Roxy and Jim as they celebrate their anniversary. Request from Linda Presley. And Ray Sinclair, brother to Maureen Staten, having open heart surgery on Monday. Request by Mark and Maureen Staten. All right. Any other prayer requests this morning? All right. Let us pray this morning. Most gracious and heavenly Father, we thank you this morning once again, Lord, for just allowing us to wake up and come into your sanctuary this morning, Lord. And Lord, we ask that you would help us, Lord, that you would touch our families, that you would touch our minds, that you would touch our hearts this morning, Lord, and that you would move and have your way in each of us, Lord, as only you can do, Lord, for we are your children, Father. Father, we thank you for these prayer requests this morning, Lord, and we know that you're able, Lord God. We know that you're able to change situations and circumstances, Lord. We know that you're able to heal. You are a healer, Lord God. Lord, we know that you are our mighty God, that you are an amazing God, that you're the peace that surpasses all understanding, Lord. You are the joy, unspeakable joy in our lives, Lord God, and we know these things, Lord. And so, Lord, we lay these requests at your feet this morning, Lord God, and we ask that you would touch each and every person, Lord God. That you would move in their hearts and minds, Lord God. Lord, we thank you that you know the very hairs on their head, Lord God, and that they're your children called by your name, Father, and we're grateful for that this morning, Lord. Lord, we ask that you would sweep through our family's house, Lord God, and that you would help us, Lord God. Help us to know you, Lord. Help us to share you, Lord God. Help us to have our minds steadfast on you, Lord. Lord, help us to not be just in the world, but that we're not of the world, Lord God, but we are in the world, Lord. Lord, remind us that we are the salt of the earth, Lord, that we're a city on a hill, Lord God, that we don't want to help us to not cover ourselves with the lampshade, Lord God, but that we would let our light shine. It reminds me of a song, "This Little Light of Mine." I'm going to let it shine, Lord God. And Lord, I can only let that light shine if you can shine through me, Lord God. If you would encourage us, Lord God, to be the body of Christ that you have called us to be, Lord. And Lord, we're just so thankful for you, Lord God. We're so thankful for what you do. We're so thankful for what you've already done, Lord God. We're so thankful that you keep us each and every day, Lord God. We are thankful, Lord, because you are King of Kings and you are Lord of Lords. And so, Father, we thank you for touching these families, Lord God. We thank you for Pastor Roxy and her husband, Lord, and their anniversary, Lord. Lord, let her be at peace today, Lord God. Let her to just have a great time today, Lord God. Let her know that you got everything under control, Lord God. And Lord, we just say thank you this morning. If we'll recite the Lord's Prayer together this morning. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive our debts as we forget our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
And speak now, for my soul is listening. Say that you have saved me. Whisper in the dark, 'cause I know you're more than my salvation. Without you, I am hopeless. Tell me who you are.
Kim, that was absolutely beautiful. I wish I could sing, but I'd spare you all. Okay. Okay, today's scripture is John 17, 20 through 26, and it's about when Jesus was in the garden, right before he was betrayed and arrested, and he's talking to his Father and asking that we all become one with him and God. So this is John 17, 20 through 26. I ask not only on behalf of these, but also on behalf of those who believe in me through their word, that they may be one, as you, Father, are in me and I am in you. May they also be in us, so that the world may believe that you have sent me. The glory that you have given me, I have given them, so that they may be one as we are one, in them and you in me, that they may be that they may become completely one, so that the world may know that you have sent me and have loved them even as you have loved me. Father, I desire that those also whom you have given me may be with me where I am, to see my glory, which you have given me because you love me before the foundation of the world. Righteous Father, the world does not know you, but I know you, and these know that you have sent me. I made your name known to them, and I will make it known, so that the love with which you have loved me may be in them and I in them. The word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Father, I thank you that you are who you are, Father. And I ask that you would move me out of the way today, Lord, and use me as your servant, Lord, in the name of Jesus. So I've been wrestling with this a little bit. I'm pretty sure I was a little late in getting the sermon title in, and because I was wrestling with the text. Anybody ever wrestle with what God tells you to do? Amen. Amen. It's not always easy to hear and be obedient, is it? So I wanted to make sure that I was in the right place as best I could, and I've been wrestling with this text for a couple of weeks now, and last Sunday I was asking God for the title. I'm not sure why I asked him for the title first of the sermon, but I did, and he gave me a dream, which doesn't happen too often. He gave me a dream, and the dream, when I woke up from the dream, the words that came to me were, when Jesus gets down on the inside. When Jesus gets down on the inside, we can do what we need to do, right, in Christ. If we can allow Jesus to get down on the inside of us, then we can move and we can be assured that he is with us wherever we go. And that he says that he would never leave us or forsake us, right? And so I ask, because Matthew 7 says that if we ask and we seek and we knock, the door shall be open, right? And so I asked. I didn't know I was asking for a dream. I didn't know that it would come that way, but that's how it came. And I'll just tell you the end of the dream. I had a good friend who passed away recently, and I was always kind of intimidated by her. She to me was a really strong, she was a bishop. When I met her, she was an elder in the AME church, and I was a quiet, person, and she would always kind of, anybody kind of nudge me a little bit. I'm assuming that she saw in me something that I did not see. But she would always nudge me and tell me to quit hiding, quit doing this. And I was like, man, Lord, she just intimidates me. But she passed away a couple of weeks ago and brought me back to thinking about her and all of the greatness that I saw her do as she went from elder to bishop and her struggles and the trials and things that she went through to get where she was. And also the many multitudes of people that she grabbed along the way to encourage them that you can do this, that I see something in you, that God is in you. And if God placed something deep down on the inside of you, you can rest assured that he's got this thing under control. He's not depending on whether you know something. He's depending on whether you have a personal relationship with him. That's what he's depending on. He's depending on if you've read your scriptures and your text, and to the best of your ability, you're trying to understand and comprehend what the Father is saying to you. He's depending on when you become from that little child that somebody would share the gospel of Jesus Christ with you. He's depending on us for that. That one day, and he already knows that day, when we'll meet him, when we'll know that we know that we know that he is our Father, that it's not about how we act or just being good or all those things or the rules and the regulations, but it's about the love that the Father has for us, right? In that, I'm going to try to stick with, I'll tell you the dream and then I'll go to the text because I can bounce around a little bit. But in the dream, it was as if I was with the bishop's sister, and I didn't meet her, so I don't know how I knew that was her sister. But she was dressed in a white robe, and her robe had like the old material that had the holes in it. like a type of a knit type of material with holes in it. And it was bright. Her robe was bright. And then the robe that was next to us, she was telling me that we got to iron this robe out. We need to iron this robe out. And I'm a hairdresser by trade, by the way. So it seemed like we were using a flat iron to iron out a robe. It seemed like we were taking that flat iron, we were going down the seams of that robe. That's what it seemed like we were doing. God's funny, right? But we got into this rhythm where we were trying to straighten out the wrinkles in this white robe. And I don't know if you've ever, it felt like we were in a cocoon. And it was such an awesome feeling. And we got into this, she was talking to me, and we were trying to iron out this robe, and we were rocking back and forth. And I could just feel the Lord's presence when I woke up. And I woke up in tears. And that's what came to me. When Jesus gets down on the inside of us. And I was like, man, I couldn't, that feeling that I had in my dream was just so real. It was just so amazing. And I thought, wow, that means that everything that we struggle with, everything that we went through when we were children and our families and every place that we've gone and all the things that we've done, if we just could get Jesus down on the inside, everything is okay. It doesn't matter if people talk about us. It doesn't matter if they don't like who we are. As long as we know Jesus, everything gonna be all right. I used to be a really quiet child. I didn't want to get in trouble. My dad was an army man. So I tried to stay two steps ahead of him. You know, I was trying to make sure I had the dishes washed and the clothes folded, and I didn't want him to come at me any kind of way. So any time I could get ahead of him and make sure everything was good, that's what I did. But I was quiet. But I was watching and I was checking things out to make sure that everything was going to be okay, because I didn't want no turbulence. But I thank God for not staying that quiet child. My clients would be like, now you really talk a lot now. And I do one-on-one. I'm not very good out in the, you know, just browsing through and But I can talk behind that chair. But that was the grace of God that helped me to be able to do that. It's getting Jesus, continuing to get Jesus on the inside. And I'm trying not to bounce around because I do that a lot. But let's that text that she wrote. And God is funny. Sometimes he puts the sermon together and I'm like, ah, Lord, I do not know where we're going, but I trust that you're going to help me. So that Matthew 17, John 17, I keep saying Matthew 17 to myself. Thank you. That Matthew 17. See, there it is again. I've been doing this all week. John 17, verses 20 through 26. See, I had the verses down, 20 through 26, right? Jesus prays for believers everywhere. I am not praying only on their behalf, but also on behalf of those who believe in me through their testimony, that they will all be one, just as you, Father, are in me and I am in you. I pray that they will be in us so that the world will believe that you sent me. The glory you gave me, I have given to them that they may be one just as we are one. I in them and you in me, that they may be completely one, so that the world will know that you sent me and you have loved them just as you have loved me. Father, I want those you have given me to be with me where I am, so that they can see my glory that you gave me because you loved me before the creation of the world. Righteous Father, even if the world does not know you, I know you, and these men know that you sent me. I've made known your name to them, and I will continue to make it known so that the love you have loved me with may be in them and I may be in them. Thank you for the Lord's word. And so I made known to your name to them, and I will continue to make it known so that the love you have loved me with may be in them and I may be in them. Jesus on the inside of us, right? He prayed, you know, and I wrestled. I saw Reverend Roxy had her stall, right? And so yesterday we had a prayer, session yesterday, and a friend of mine brought me this prayer shawl. And it had it in my bag this morning, and I was having a conversation with a friend, and I felt led to put it on this morning. How ironic, right? Jesus is praying for us. I went to a prayer thing yesterday, and today I have this prayer shawl, right? And I thought, ooh, I'm going to put my prayer shawl on. And yesterday we gave the ladies some prayer blankets, and we had prayed over them. And when I put this shawl over my head yesterday, I could feel the presence of the Lord. I was having a conversation with a pastor friend of mine, and she was telling me that she used to pray with her blanket over her head. And I thought, I do that. And she was saying that that she did not realize the Lord had brought it to her that these prayer shawls that they wear, it's like having them in their own closet, right? In their own prayer closet. So they wear these, and whenever they walked around, they could just stop and pray. Isn't that neat? And our Father prayed. Jesus prayed for us. The Son of God prayed for us. He prayed for the future believers. He prayed for himself. He prayed for the disciples. He wanted to make sure that we understood that him and the Father are one, right? If you see Jesus, then you see the Father, right? And so how much more as he left us the gift of the Holy Spirit, right? That dwells on the inside of us, that we begin to pick up those characteristics. We begin to move and have our way with the Spirit of the Lord that lives in each of us. How much more can we do when we follow that? How much more? We don't have to think we can't do things, because the Word of God says that we can do things. It says that we are fearfully and wonderfully made. It says that we are loving our neighbors as ourselves. We ought to love our neighbors as ourselves. You know, the part that I realize that we miss sometimes is that we don't love ourselves. But we have a Savior that loves us, right? We have a Savior that says all these things that we begin to understand, and when we begin to understand that, we can love what he is doing inside of us. We can love and know that when Jesus gets down on the inside of us, nothing is impossible. We can pray for our enemies. We can pray for the people that we're with on a daily basis. We can pray in our workplaces. We can pray for the children that we see, and we're celebrating the children's Sabbath, right? And I used to think there's a little girl in me that needed to be healed. And there's a song that says, "Dear Younger Me." Anybody know that song? Dear Younger Me. What do you say to that dear younger me? And I thought about this. I would say, it's okay to speak. I would say that God loves you. I would say that you are fearfully and wonderfully made. I would say, trust in the Father. My identity is in him. Our identity is in Christ. It's not in how we think. It's not in how we look. It's in Christ. I can tell her that now. And once we have the Father inside of us, then we begin to help other people, don't we? We don't have to worry about our inadequacies that we think, but we just follow God's word and we help other people day in and day out. So I was thinking about the homeless children. I live in Bloomington, and I'm about a block away from, there's a park across from Kroger in Bloomington, and there are lots of homeless people in that park. And most mornings I sit on my porch and I see those homeless people, and I see sometimes those women have their children or their little children. Even I've crossed paths with young folks that I've met. There's one particular young lady that I met that I was doing her hair and before COVID, and at some point during COVID, she ended up on the streets, and I thought, my Lord, that little girl was asking me questions. She was innocent, and I see her walking out here on the streets. But it's important that we as the body of Christ be able to identify and see ourselves in those children, right, and those people that we meet on day in and day out, and share the testimony that God has given us. Anybody here have a testimony? Anybody got a testimony? Have you been through something? And who brought you out? Okay? And so all we got to do is share what God's done in our lives. That's how we have Jesus down on the inside of us. So I just wanted to share with you today. I know that I'm not Reverend Roxy by any means. I was watching. I was like, woo. Man, I love the way she's so clear and so precise and how she moves. And I just love her spirit in general. But I had to come to you as Angela Carter this morning.
I like you.
Thank you. I had to come to you as Angela Carter this morning because that's who God created me to be. And I can't go back and keep thinking about, you know, all the other stuff that everybody else does because I'm me and you are you, right? And we make up the body of Christ. We are the hands and feet of Jesus Christ. So remember, when Jesus gets down on the inside, it's not always just the one-time thing. It's a continual knocking on that door. Lord, I need your help. Lord, I'm going over here. This morning I called a couple friends. Lord, I'm going to FCC this morning and I'm going to need some prayer. Lord, I need you to be with me. Lord, thank you for the prayer shawl that you gave me on yesterday. Lord, I thank you that I put it on and I can feel your presence this morning. Lord, you are awesome and mighty and amazing. Amazing grace. You know that song? Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. I was blind, but now God, we can see, right? Thank God we can see. Amen. Father, we thank you this morning that you help us to see, Lord. Lord, thank you that you saw fit to allow your son to pray for us. Even before we believe, Lord God, we just thank you this morning, Father. We thank you that he had the right words to say, Lord God. We thank you that he knew he had a purpose when he got here, Lord God. We thank you that you sent him to that cross to die for our sins, Lord God, and for the sins of the whole world, Lord God. We say thank you this morning, Lord. Thank you for your amazing grace, Lord God. Thank you for your amazing grace, Lord God. And Lord, we just ask that you would continue to be with us. You said you would never leave us or forsake us, Lord. And so we're dependent on that this morning, Lord God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. I thought I would share with you this morning for our communion invitation a poem by Frank Carpenter. Beloved child, though you have wandered far from me, though your very nature repelled me, though your rebellion was deserving of death, I love you still, beloved child. Because of my boundless love for you, I reached out across time for you. I reached out beyond sin for you. I reached out to rescue you. Because of my love for you, beloved child, because of my perfect love for you, I took your sin upon myself. I bore the cross you should have borne. I died the death which you deserved. I sacrificed my life for you, all for the love of you, beloved child. Because of my sacrificial love for you, I canceled your iniquity. I cleansed you from the stain of sin. I washed you whiter than snow. I bought you for eternal life. Because of my love for you, I am my Father's beloved child. But his love for you is such that he offered me on your behalf. He offered me to suffer and die, that he might draw you back unto himself. Because of his great love for you, beloved child, because of my gracious love for you, I gave my body to be broken for you. I gave my blood to be poured out for you, the blood of my covenant and my forgiveness. These I offered willingly because of my love for you. Remember always my love for you. May the bread and the cup ever be tokens between us, taken because of your love for me. And when the hour came, he reclined at the table, and the apostles with him. And he said to them, I have earnestly desired to eat this Passover with you before I suffer. For I tell you, I will not eat it until it is fulfilled in the kingdom of God. And he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he said, take this and divide it among yourselves. You can keep me on track. I need a little help this morning. Which are you doing the prayer after I get done? Okay.
Yeah, when
I tell you? All right. Do we want to take the, do we take it before you do the prayer?
Do the prayer and then we take it.
Okay. I'll let you do the prayer.
Okay.
Okay. Oh God, let us always remember that you have provided for our deepest needs. We trust in you because you have sent your Son, Jesus Christ, to live amongst us, not to be served, but to serve, and to offer his life as ransom for all. As we remember your Son, Jesus Christ, while taking of this bread and cup, we pray that you will strengthen us in our service to you. Amen.
All right, now I'm going to read the scripture, okay? And when the hour came, he reclined at the table, and the apostles with him, and he said to them, I have earnestly desired to eat this Passover with you before I suffer. For I tell you, I will not eat it until it is fulfilled in the kingdom of God. And he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he said, take this, divide it among yourselves. For I tell you that from now on, I will not drink of the fruit of the vine until the kingdom of God comes. And he took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to them, saying, this is my body, which is given for you. Let's take the bread. Do this in remembrance of me. And likewise, the cup after they had eaten, saying, this is the cup that is poured out for you in the new covenant of my blood.
For Wellsprings. Okay. Before we join our voices in our offering meditation, I would like to remind you that we will be taking a special offering at this time. Today's special offering is for Wellspring Family Homeless Shelter, and you can find more information about this organization in your bulletin. Now, please join us in this responsive offering meditation. It will be found on the screen and in your bulletin. O God of the children of Somalia, Sarajevo, South Africa, and South Carolina,
of Albania, Alabama, Bosnia, and Boston, of Krakow and Cairo, Chicago, and Croatia,
help us all respect and protect us all.
O God of children of destiny and of despair, of war and of peace, of disfigured disease and dying children,
of children without hope and of children with hope to spare and share,
help us to love and respect and protect them all.
Today we light a candle for children who are affected by homelessness and hunger, who are affected by poverty and prejudice, who struggle with physical and mental health, who are affected by abuse and neglect. And we light the Christ candle, which calls us to be Christ's light to all children everywhere.
Jesus, as you have provided for all of our needs, let us joyfully give back a portion of what you have given to us, so that your word can reach all those who have not had the privilege of knowing you. Let our offering be used in your holy name to help provide those in our community and throughout the world. Please guide us in the best ways to do so. Amen.
So, faith in action. We have a lot going on today. Discipleship hour. All classes will be meeting. Children upstairs. Wired Word upstairs. The other class in 1:30. High school and Faith Walkers, and the Chosen is in 1:30. Middle school is in the Teen Cafe, and I don't know, is Danielle here today? So I tell you what, middle school, let's meet up in the Faith Walkers room with the high school, okay? How many of you, let's have a show of hands, are coming to pumpkin carving? We want you to come. Invite someone. There are more cards that if you know of a family, write their name, send them a postcard. I've been asked to announce that there will be a young adult retreat, and I think there's some young adults back there in the crow's nest. November 1st through the 3rd at Bedford. It costs $75, but if you come see me, you might get a break on that, okay? So, young adult retreat, it's the region. Mission trip. All of you have this little slip of paper. Last year, about 30 of us went and packed up meals that were going all kinds of places. Saturday, this coming Saturday, Anne needs to know, how many of you will be willing to go and pack up food? It's fun. Actually, I went last year. Sign up over at the Welcome Center, okay? All ages, kids included.
What time is bus leaving?
The bus will leave at 10 o'clock in the morning, and it's for all ages. I mean, we had kids up through, I won't mention the highest, but it was past me, okay? And they'll be back here at 2. Parents, youth, over on the windowsill, there's a postcard with all the camp dates. You might want to take one of those home to remind yourself. Okay, does anybody else have something that's going on that I've missed?
Okay. Soup Sunday next
week. Soup Sunday next week. So bring your $5.
Yeah. Well, yeah, $4 if you bring your jar back.
Okay. So dig way down inside you as children of God. We all have a little Christ within us. And so this week your challenge is to let that little bit of Christ that's within you shine forth as you show someone your love, Christ's love, through you. Okay? We're the hands and feet of Christ. So, trust and obey. Let's sing 556. Trust and obey.